This commentary is a tool, a guidance tool for practitioners to apply, who have to apply and interpret the Third Geneva Convention. So it contains a detailed commentary on every provision on the 143 articles. It's an article by article commentary giving further guidance and details on the meaning and interpretation of these specific provisions.
The previous commentary was finished in 1958, and obviously in the last 60 years there's been many developments in the area of law, but also in the way we understand how armed conflict is fought and the certain protections needed for individuals. So we really needed to update and find a refreshed way, a modern way of ensuring that the protections are understood and applied.
The process starts with research into the sources to capture these developments in law and practice, and on this basis initial drafts are produced, and then these drafts go through various review stages. An important step in this review process is the peer review process, which includes 50 external experts, both academics and practitioners, who have reviewed each draft in their personal capacity, and their feedback has been integrated.
We aim for those who actually have to apply the Geneva Conventions, particularly the Third Geneva Convention, to be those who would find this updated commentary the most useful. So of course that means states, that means diplomats, members of the armed forces, but also policymakers and those who are interested in understanding more about international humanitarian law.
It's a very useful tool that helps commanders, that helps army people to understand what exactly shall be done in order to respect and comply with the IHL today.
أما على صعيد القوات المسلحة فالتعليقات الجديدة ونشرها بين صفوف المقاتلين سيعني بالتأكيد تقليل التفسير الخاطئ والحد من الخروقات بشكل كبير.
I've never seen a military commander, I have never seen a soldier who would tell me that no, I'm not going to comply with IHL because I'm against it. No, never. But I have many who told me, well, okay, this is clear, but technically, on the ground, what am I supposed to do? So that is the question that commentary is actually answering.
Military lawyers know that ICRC commentaries are treated with respect, and they carry a great deal of weight. In those circumstances, it's obvious that even when they may disagree with the contents of the commentary, they're going to want to know what the commentary actually says. In that respect, it's a very important resource for military lawyers and through them, their commanders.
Los comentarios nos ofrecen diversos puntos importantes y también aportes que destacamos como valiosos. Por un lado, podríamos señalar aquellos criterios que establecen para determinar los alcances de la definición del artículo 4 sobre prisioneros de guerra. Asimismo, desarrollan algunos criterios respecto de los cuales debemos de tener en cuenta para determinar si una persona pertenece o no a las Fuerzas Armadas, con lo cual hay un impacto respecto de las medidas de protección que establecen el convenio.
In the last 60 years, we have seen a vast increase in the number of women directly participating in hostilities. So you will see in this updated commentary a much more clearly articulated area relating to female prisoners of war, in particularly their protections and issues such as privacy.
The commentary is also important because it hasn't avoided some of the difficult issues. This includes things like the relationship with international human rights law. It also includes some of the issues such as the use of force in relation to prisoners of war.
سأعمل على استخدام تعليقات محدثة بين طلبتي وخصوصا في الدراسات العليا لتحديد النقاط التي يمكن أن تشكل تحديا أمام تطبيق أحكام اتفاقية جنيف الثالثة من خلال إعداد دراسات متخصصة لتسليط الضوء على النقطة المركزية وهي أنه كيف تتعامل القوى الحاجزة مع الأسرى كبشر.
En el campo del derecho internacional humanitario, sobre todo en aquellos actores que tenemos la labor de promover la implementación, los comentarios nos van a permitir tener una herramienta sólida con aspectos técnicos y jurídicos que alienten no solo el trabajo con los diversos actores, sino que además refuerce nuestra labor y haga que nuestras tareas se hagan mucho mejor.
While with electronic documents these days, you don't need to be too careful about what you take with you. You can always fit things on a disc. I think if you're still going on a deployment or you're going to a conference or to a meeting where prisoners of war issues are going to be discussed in any great detail, I think you should probably find room for a hard copy of this particular commentary.